that are still in Kagoma camp. And the Kagoma camp for 15 years. And you can imagine what that would be like every day based on services that are just routine. Very meager services, but nonetheless, very little freedom to express their own skills and their own enterprise. And so that's a needs-based system. So then when they walk back into this system here, there is a sort of service-oriented paradigm that they're still part of. And so what we encourage and all the people that are working with refugees is to have a people-centered sort of approach. And that approach means that we're going to explore gifts, we're going to explore their own capacities. And we do this by exploring different things that are part of who they are. And so I have three different categories that I use: head, hands, heart.
Why are you showing us how to do this if they're not coming here?
Amen.
Good question.
Yeah. Why?
The reason is total education.
Why?
So, it's just for information and education, so we have a better understanding. Understanding is really important. So if we have, we have the head, the things that people know and like to express. I have an Iraqi friend who.
Trying to shut the doors in this country with all the trash.
We have things of the hand.
Be a gentleman. Shut up.
Soccer, various things of crafts, and incredible gifts that are expressed by refugees, and then the things of the heart, the things that they're passionate about, whether it's children's education, or the environment, whatever it is. And so the whole idea is we move from away from doing to, and we do with. And this is a friendship, and there's a mutuality to it. So that's the idea of self-sufficiency.
They don't do with. They don't assimilate.
Experiencing loss, like when your buddies get murdered by one of these people.
Right. Would you let them talk, please?
They're not talking.
We want to listen.
You want them? You have in your house. Keep out of
my
community.
Wait until they're done. Can you do that?
You saw those things that if your friend's been killed, then you shut up.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go ahead and start addressing the questions. Now, please realize that some of the questions these people may not have answers for. So, absolutely. I mean, if they have answers, then certainly they will give them to you. But if they do not, well then, I'm going to keep all of the questions. I'm going to see how we can find answers for you later. So the schools are full. Let's please be quiet so that everyone can hear the question. And I'll come around and get more questions.
Why can't the person answer? If they don't have the answer, that's fine. But read all the questions.
Right. Read them all. Yeah.
Let the people read their own questions.
As much as time allows, we will. The schools are full.
We have an hour.
The school. I will wait now.
If you don't have the answer, just say we don't have the answer. But read the question.
She's trying to.
So, ladies and gentlemen, if we're ready for questions and I'm ready to read them.
You're just in here in this community, stand up right now. So let them put that there,
baby. Okay. You're against it.
Understand your enemy. These people are the enemy.
we know we don't want
to. To let the first one.
Okay, let's go ahead and read.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's very difficult to read questions when there's competition for the airspace in that way.
Good question. That area.
We're going to try a couple of questions. If it does not go to where it's a respectful conversation, then we may not read all the questions because I will not have our presenters attack verbally. The schools are full. Where are you going to put these kids? There are 36 kids in my son's first grade class. No room. Keep them away. We don't want them. There are no refugees coming here, and they are not being added to the schools, so I can answer that one.
Why are we wasting our time here?
Why should we believe that?
I don't know. The purpose of this was to go on ahead and to do a training for those that have asked for a training on how they could help. There were different community members. I don't have a list of names.
Was it the mayor?
Who takes care of these people after the 3 or 8 months that their assistance runs out?
I'll address that by just going over.
Just answer the question.
Okay, well, the quick answer is that in the short run, there is a there are resources that are given to refugees, and that there's no question about that.
But
if you look at even the short term and then even the longer term, you will find a net contribution to the tax base. If you look at the studies that have been done, there is a net contribution by refugees, and that's just, there are study after study that can show that. I could show you some of the data, but I'm just going to give a quick answer on that.
What organization is funding your endeavor of refugee relocation? Any Christian organizations?
Like I said at the beginning, we are an organization through our local church in Boise, Cole Community. We do not receive any government funding. We do not receive funding for these trainings that we do in Boise. They are all free and they are for volunteers. And as far as the agencies, that's a different story. The resettlement agencies work with government funding. That would be International Rescue Committee, Agency for New Americans, and CESI and TWIN.
You bring the people here then, right?
We do not bring people here. We receive, we welcome them, but we don't do, we don't physically go and say this person gets to come.
Are you ready?
Does this presentation basically apply or only to refugees, or does it also apply to all immigrants? What is the difference?
Refugees are people who have been forced by persecution to cross a border. There's a conflict and they've been forced. There's a variety of reasons that persecution exists, but that's the difference. So an immigrant doesn't have that same definition. A refugee actually has to apply for refugee status. When a refugee first starts out, they're really an asylee because they cross a border without any sort of a status. Once they cross that border and register with the UNHCR, the High Commissioner for Refugees, then they get refugee status. Otherwise, if they come for economic reasons, that's what you would call an immigrant.
So they can come.
If they have to get a job in 3 to 8 months, how come unemployment was extended to 2 years? Our citizens often can't find work.
I don't understand.
So the question really is, if they have to get a job in 3 to 8 months, how come unemployment was extended to 2 years? Do you know anything about that?
It's Yeah, that may be a case, but you've got to look at the aggregate data. And the aggregate data says that, in fact, there's a contribution to the economy. After 18 months, you begin to see positive contributions. If you look over 25 years...
If he's employed.
You've got $77 billion that's being contributed to the U.S. economy as of last year by refugees.
No, that's a lie.
That is actually...
Big lie.
And I can show you the study.
That's a lot of yogurt.
Well, you don't need to believe it.
Erdogan wrote the study.
Ladies and gentlemen... If they're not going to be treated well, then I will stop the questions because it's
questions are hard, so stop it.
Yeah.
Don't allow questions.
I think that's a good idea.
Questions.
You're not answering the questions.
The truth is
that there is no rhyme or reason to blue or white cards.
We can't get jobs in 3 months as it is, so how can they, unless they have preferential treatment?
What?
We have all kinds of people that can't get work in 6 months.
This is, let's see if I can read it right. Daniel and friend were POWs. I'm sorry,
I don't think it's a question. Daniel and Fran were POWs. Zeph, Maya, and Ezra were not refugees, but also taken in war.
Comment.
Can we hear that now?
It makes sense.
Can you say it so we can hear it?
When you
hear
it on
the microphone, can you hold it closer to your face so we can actually hear you speaking, please?
It was a comment about one of the people from the Bible. Daniel and Fran were POWs. I'm assuming... Nehemiah, maybe, or Zephaniah, Nehemiah and Ezra were not refugees, but also taken in war. It was a comment. It was not a question.
And Christ wasn't a refugee. He was on his way to a census. You should know that if you're Bible teachers. Now let her read the question.
Just read.
Questions.
Don't shut up.
Are these families or military men?
Men.
Oh, are these families or military men? Thank you.
So, there are families that come generally. It's the majority are women and children that actually come as refugees. That's the vast majority. Or complete unit families. Many also, we have special interest visas, men who were interpreters in Afghanistan and Iraq often also come as SIV visas, but refugees, because they were working alongside our U.S. military, and they also come under the refugee program.
Are they Syrian, Somali, Iraqi, Iranian, or where are they from? Are these Syrian, Somali, Iranian, Iraqi, or where are they from? I think if we answered that one. Okay, thank you. Where are they going to work? We don't have a strong job market.
At the mill.
And I think it's not jobs that are going to be here because they're not coming here. So they are going to be trained in various jobs from what I got from their training there. Are they Muslims? Do they follow Islam?
Then why are you here pushing this down our throats? That's what I want to know. We don't want
it. This was a voluntary attended. This was a voluntary attended training that was advertised to go on ahead and to include people that wanted to be here to see how to go on ahead and to work with refugees. There is no other intention, there is no hidden agenda there. The next question. Are they Muslims? Do they follow Islam?
There are some Muslims that come. The majority are actually, if you look at the data, there's 2/3 that are Christian that come.
95%!
this evening.